There was no sound system, no loudspeakers, nothing. 100,000 people. India is a land of teeming millions. 100,000, what they can listen, but no. They just want to enjoy the fun. The 100,000 are there. People nearby, they can hear. But the people at the back, they're just asking, what did he say? Say, Maulana gave one uppercut. He gave like this, he gave like that. Somebody's giving commentary at the back. So the debate took place between Maulana Abdul Aziz of Delhi and Reverend Founder, the Britisher. And the Britisher, Reverend Founder, started by suggesting to the Maulana that Maulana Sahib, Sheikh, respected Sheikh, get started. Get started with the debate. So the Maulana says, look, you Christians are our elder brothers. Christianity preceded Islam by 600 years. So you are 600 years older than us. Christianity came first. And according to our culture, our elder brother has the first chance. So you are our elder brother, you get started. Number two, you are our guest. You are a visitor, our guest. No doubt an unwelcome guest, but still you are our guest. So according to our culture, the guest has the first chance. So the Reverend was forced to start. And he started with a question. In Urdu, in our native language, like here, if it was here in Swahili. So you don't know English? Swahili. Your Shah, come on, talk to me. So the Reverend started, this is Maulana Sahib, respected Sheikh. Where is your Prophet Muhammad now, this minute? Where is he now, this moment? Where is he? So the Maulana thought for a moment, and he said that for Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Holy Prophet Muhammad is in Jannatul Firdaus, in heavenly bliss, in paradise. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of that answer came the second question. He said, all right, tell us, Maulana Sahib, respected Sheikh, tell us, where was your Prophet Muhammad when his grandson Hussein was martyred at Karbala, was slaughtered, killed? Where was he then? So the Maulana again thought for a moment. And he said, he was still in Jannatul Firdaus, heavenly bliss with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of that answer came the third question. It was planned, strategy. He said, all right, tell us now, Maulana Sahib, that if your Muhammad was with his Allah, did he not ask Allah for help? He said, look, they're killing my grandson, please save him. Did he not ask his Allah for help? So the Maulana thought for a long time, and the Reverend felt he had him cornered. So he started stamping his feet. Come on, come on. Did he not ask his Allah for help? So the Maulana started slowly. He said, yes, he did. He did. Natural thing to do. He did ask Allah for help. Then what did Allah say? Because we know he wasn't saved. And there was an inordinate pause, a very long pause. And the Reverend again started banging his feet. Come on, come on. What did Allah say? And the people felt that this Maulana got us all cooked. Finished. He's finished us up. Finished. This Maulana has got caught out. Come on, come on. So the Maulana slowly, he said, Allah cried. Allah cried. So what? Allah cried? He said, yes, Allah cried. He said, I couldn't save my own son, Jesus. How can I save your grandson? And the debate was over. The debate was over, finished, knockout, knockout blow.